So, Unit 8, we have studied about the comparison and what are the things we are comparing. That also we have studied how to compare, and if it is changed into from this to that and that to this, what are the precautions to be taken. This all we have discussed in 8th unit. Now, repetition. In any language, repetition is a bad. That is bad practice. Why? Because the word which we use, and if it is once again used, once again used, once again used, you see how many times I am telling once again, once again, once again. That gives a kind of boredom to the listener. Why do we speak? Why do we write? We write and we speak to please the others. That we have to keep in our mind. And hence, repetition of the same phrase, same word, same sentence, it is regarded as a bad practice, or rather we can say bad language. Now I have written certain things on board for you. In this language, that is in our Hindi language, not only Hindi language, in any Indian language, repetition of words, there is a complete usage, I mean, how to use it, use them, where to use them, in what context to use them. It has been put, and that usage of the repetition of words or phrases have been restricted to that area only. Now if you see in Hindi, chalte chalte, when we say chalte chalte, repetition, word we have repeated, but what is the effect of it? Effect of it is different. That means you have to do a certain thing while going. To give the meaning of while going, we are using the word chalte chalte and here dekhte dekhte, while seeing, and chalte chalte. Chalte chalte, ye mere geet yaad rakhna. That way the lyricist has written and used that word chalte chalte. Means while we are going. It is a very beautiful usage there. Means you repeat it as long as the language becomes beautiful and acceptable. Two things we have to remember. Language, we have to beautify it, or we have to make it acceptable to others. Then repetition, it is a very good thing, we can do it. And again, if you see ulta seedha, one word is positive, the other word is negative of it. Those two are also paired up to bring about the beauty in Hindi language. Wah ulta seedha ho gaya, magar kaam nahi kar paya. Means the failure has been shown with his efforts. Ulta seedha ho jana means he has put a very large amount of effort, but he could not succeed. That way we are using the one positive word and one negative word. This usage is there in Hindi, in every language. And aate jate huye. Aate jate means what? Some people are coming, some people are going. You are also going and you are also coming. While doing so, you are completing a certain thing. See the beauty of it when we are using repeated words, or the words repeatedly. If that has been brought into English, let us see, can we use quickly, quickly? Most of the people I have seen, they use it. He went quickly, quickly. He went quickly, quickly. From where this language has come into English? He is jaldi jaldi chala gaya. Jaldi jaldi chala gaya. There in Hindi it is acceptable and beautified. But here he went quickly, quickly. It doesn't sound good. Right? And again, I have written a sentence for you here, you can see. I went to market. I purchased books. I wanted to return home. I was caught in the rain. What is repeated? I have used and people could understand what I have written. But the very same thing could be written in a very beautiful manner without repeating this I everywhere. That is called avoiding repetition. And most of the people we can see, these connections or these conjunctions, they use in a very frequent manner in their language, and they make the language ugly. And then, that also means they want to connect it. Flow is not there. A long ways is a long ways when there is a flow. It should have the flow. And then the stoppages by means of repetition, using the connectors and using them repeatedly, this has been regarded as bad practice in any language. So about that we are going to read now, and the whole lesson we can compress it for whatever the thing has been used over there, how to eliminate repetition. So here we can eliminate repetition, and we can drop that "and" only whenever it is necessary, there only we have to use. If not, the usage of connectors or standby words, these are not necessary. Then is standby thing, not necessary. And you know, they use it in such a frequent manner, it becomes a habit for them. So this repetition we have to leave out, avoid it. We can see certain examples also here. I want to scale Mount Everest. I want to do scuba diving. And I want to fly an aeroplane. Actually, I want to do a lot of things before I die. It is very good to read and hear also. But thing what we have to see here is repeated I want, is it necessary to do so? We can use a simple comma between, and you can all put all the things which I want to do in a single sentence. I want to scale Mount Everest, scuba diving, fly an aeroplane, and actually do most of the things or a lot of things before I die. Only one sentence. I have used commas only. Lastly, I have used "and". Then all the five sentences I put together. Whatever I wanted to do, that only I have taken that part. That is called beautification of the language, eliminating, avoiding repetition. Now, former and latter, we have the two words. These we can use. How? Mrs. Sharma went to see a picture. Mrs. Shanti, she too went to see a picture. Mrs. Shanti met Mrs. Sharma in the lounge of the cinema hall. Both were talking. Mrs. Sharma called Mrs. Shanti to her house for a dinner. Mrs. Shanti said that she cannot come or could not come. Mrs. Shanti said that she is engaged otherwise. You see, we have written a very good thing, very good. But what we have done is we have repeated Mrs. Sharma, Mrs. Shanti, Mrs. Sharma, Mrs. Shanti. There, very comfortably, we can avoid using the names, putting the what is it, former and latter. About whom we start talking first is the former. About whom we talk later is latter. That way we can put, only once we are putting Mrs. Sharma and Mrs. Shanti over there. Thereafter what we are putting is here is former and latter. The former called the latter for a dinner, but the latter denied her invitation. That way, furthermore beautification we can do for the thing what we are talking, right? And there are certain questions we see. What is the question? Did you buy the dress you had seen in the shop? The question. Did you buy the dress you had seen in the shop? This is a question we ask over a telephone. What shall I expect as an answer? No, I did not buy the dress which I have seen in the shop. Is it necessary? No. Simply I can say, no, I didn't. No, I didn't. Yes, I did. Right? And do so. These are the words. I have seen him doing so. I asked him to complete the homework. I witnessed him doing so. I need not put again the homework here. Likewise, there are certain phrases, there are certain words which can comfortably replace the words which you have used once. Why? In language, to use a word repeatedly, it is regarded as wrong. Most of the people we see, they say quickly. Coming, or running, he reached there. From where did he come running, he reached there? Then when I analyzed, I could able to understand, daudte aur pahunch gaya. Daudte wo pahunch gaya. This has been translated into, in English, running, he reached there. This is what it appears funny when we use such kind of a repetitive words. So you see the exercise over there, very beautiful exercise have been given there. And if you practice them, then what happens is the repetition of words or phrases can be eliminated. And for that, you should have very good vocabulary also. You have to increase your vocabulary. Then only we can eliminate these things. If I don't know a certain word, how to express this thing? So simply one thing I will tell you. Eliminate, discard. Eliminate and discard. Eliminate, discharged. See the thing, when I am using the word eliminate, everywhere I am using that, it becomes stale. It may stink even. Then discharged, discarded, suspended, he had been sent home. He was asked not to. See how many things. One word I am using or phrases I am using to give the same meaning. That way we should be well versed with the words which can replace the earlier word. Can replace only because it is regarded as synonym. But actual meaning the same? No. That way we cannot. They are either by feeling or by expression or by some other thing, they may be differing, but they can be used as the synonym. And so this facility has been put over there. To express in a positive manner, we are using synonym. To express in a negative manner, we are using antonyms. That means the words we should have, more and more words. If we have more and more words, repetition doesn't occur at all. When it falls dark, what I mean to say is when the night approaches, when it is night. You see, when darkness approaches, when darkness falls, that also we are using. Right? That way we have to see for the other alternatives when we are writing and when we are talking, speaking to others, so that the listener should not become bored, feel bored. And the reader, there are certain writers are there, and you know and I know also, right from very beginning to till date also, there are many people writing many things. When you read certain thing, You feel extremely happy. Why? If you read a certain thing, you feel to discard it. I don't want to read it. That way you may feel to discard it. Why? Because of the language, how it has been used. That is, whether you are changing a word for the same context, it does not mean that you are showing your word power, but you are inwardly teaching them, make them learn, this word is also there, can be used like this. Right? So, how the words can be created? That is, certain words are verbs. Certain words are adjectives. Certain verbs are nouns. Words are adverbs. We know all these things. I am not telling something new. But this noun can be doing some modification, we can make into adjective. And these adjectives can be made into verbs. Verbs can be made into nouns. If at all we know what is the thing we have to do to make that verb act as a noun here, then you could be able to produce more words, more meaningful words. Then repetition can be stopped over there. And hence we have, in the next chapter, what we have is, it is called as a nominalization. Nominalization, nom. If I say this nom here, not N-O-R-M, nom. Then we understand nom means name. Name means a noun. Means to create a noun from a given verb, a given adjective. That is called nominalization. This word you must have heard in many contexts. Nominee. If at all we have to go to a bank and we are opening an account, there they want nominee. Nominee means we have to name somebody who is next to you to have that money withdrawn. That means to do the transaction in that account. Nominee. Nomenclature, they put. There are many items in the store. Where is that? All these things, it is very easily can be traced out. If you have the nomenclature of it, and what is to be called at what, whether it is a digited or whether it is alphabetical, that way if you know, that is called nomenclature. This is actually the method of naming it. So now that is chapter and how best we can use it, how to use it, where to use it, why to use it, those are things we will be learning in Unit 10.